Good evening, graduates, proud parents, grandparents, and friends. Congratulations, Wildcats. You are now officially adults. What does this mean? You no longer are blocked from Facebook and YouTube. You don't have to go to the bathroom one at a time or ask for permission. You can be in the hall without fear of being caught. You can use your cell phone or iPod during the day, whenever you want to, and no one will take it away from you. You don't immediately get up out of your chair and shuffle out of the room if you hear a bell. Yes, you are an adult. You're done. You made it. And you're on to the next chapter in your life. Some of your parents are sad that you're moving away. Some are happy that you're moving away. And some are just relieved that you made it through. But here's some advice for graduates and parents. As Dr. Seuss said, don't cry because it's over, smile because it happened. Now on to some hopefully useful advice for your future. I've come up with three L's of life. Learn always, love what you do, and laugh. First, learn always. A high school student was asked the following question on national television. A fifth of Americans can't locate the U.S. on a world map. Why do you think that is? Here's her response. I personally believe that U.S. Americans are unable to learn because some people out there in our nation don't have maps, and I believe that our education, like such as in South Africa and the Iraq and everywhere like such as, I believe they should. Our education over here in the U.S. should help the U.S., should help South Africa, and should help the Iraq and the Asian countries so that we will be able to build up our future for our children. If you don't know what I'm talking about, go home and look up Miss Teen USA South Carolina on YouTube. She will convince you to never stop learning. Learning is a lifelong process. Second, love what you do. Remember that everyone can excel if you just find what you love to do and do it. For example, penguins have short, fat wings that are useless on land. However, when they enter the water, they can soar, glide, dart, and dive. They excel in the water, but they don't on land. We are much different. Every one of us can truly excel at whatever we set our minds on. We need only find the right conditions to make life a truly wonderful experience. Larry H. Miller started out working in the parts department, but with hard work and a motivation to do what he truly loved, he owned the 10th largest collection of car dealerships in the nation, worth billions of dollars. Life is an adventure. On any given day, an animal may enjoy a hearty meal or become one, such as life. It's often exciting, sometimes frightening, and ultimately fatal. So what are we to do? Dive into life and enjoy the journey. Forrest Gump said, life is like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're gonna get. Third, laugh. Research shows that laughter can reduce pain, improve job performance, and help your blood vessels function better. Every experience has some element to laugh at, whether it's a comedy or a tragedy. Life comes at you fast. Remember to take it with a dose of humor. At Duke University, there are two students taking organic chemistry. The weekend before the chemistry final on Monday, they decided to go up to the University of Virginia for a party. They ended up staying longer than they planned, and they didn't make it back to Duke until early Monday morning. Rather than taking the final then, they found the professor after the final and made up a story that they went up to Virginia for the weekend, had a flat tire on the way. On the way back, didn't have a spare, and couldn't get back in time. The professor thought this over and agreed that they could make up the final the following day. Two guys were elated and relieved. They went in the next day at the time arranged. The professor placed them in separate rooms and handed each of them a test booklet. The first problem was something simple and worth 5 points. They did that problem and then turned the page. They were unprepared, however, for what happened next. When they turned the next page, it said, for 95 points, which tire? Funny story, but from it we learned several times. which is honesty and integrity are a vital piece of our character. Don't ever forget that. My final piece of graduation advice, don't always follow the crowd, but do believe in camaraderie. We all need our time alone, but there will always be a particular magic in sharing a moment with a larger group. Whether it's the thrill of cheering for the same football team, the joy of late start on those rare Fridays, or the agony of Thursday advisories, no offense, Mr. Johnson. There's an undeniable power in belonging to a group. We will always be Woods Cross Wildcats, no matter where your path takes you. If you meet a Woods Cross Wildcat in a distant country 20 years from now, whether you were good friends, just in the same class together, or your only connection when you pass in the hall a few times, you will instantly have a bond because you're part of the Wildcat graduating class of 2010. Congratulations on making it this far, and good luck in all you do. May the force be with you. Live long and prosper.